to thank all of you for coming today to honor Mary and her life. It was a precious life, a life well lived. Although she's left us at a young age, we know that God's plan will go forward, and God has a plan for all of us. The Bible tells us that every hair on our head is numbered, and God is the one that knows the day and the hour that he'll call us home. But I want to thank you for coming. It's a wonderful show of appreciation for Mary and her life. At times like these, when we lose a loved one, you know, there's nowhere in this world for us to turn for comfort, because our hearts are broken. And so many times we don't know how we're going to face the next day. But God has a plan. God has a plan. And if we put our faith in the Lord, and always look to Him when we need that strength and that help to get by, all we have to do is ask Him, and He'll be there for us. I've had to do it so many times, ask God to help me to get through a day or get through a service or get through a time of great loss. And He's always been there. He said, I'll never leave you or forsake you, but I'll be there always for you. And not only is He with us here today and with us every day that we're here on this earth, you know, God has a plan for us when we leave this world that is comforting for all of us to remember. Jesus, when He was talking to His disciples, and they were questioning Him about death, questioning Him about what's going to happen to us, where are we going to go? Jesus said to them, He said, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Jesus told them, said, you don't have to worry about what's going to be in front of you. When we leave this world, when our time comes, Jesus said, I've already got a mansion for you over in glory. He said, I will come and get you. I will come and get you. You don't have to make that trip alone. Jesus said, I will come and get you, take you there myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And those are such comforting words for should be for all of us. You know, Jesus came and took Mary home. She didn't have to go alone, and she wasn't alone, but Jesus was there, and He took her home. So I hope you can think about those things, even though your hearts are broken and the grief just wells up in you. Just think about the good things. And as we go through this service, hopefully we'll be able to bring you a little bit of brightness in this day of great sadness. Because God is love. God is love. And God loves each one of us. Each one of us. All of us were created equal in His sight. And He loves us all equally. So as Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Let us pray. Father, today we Lord, have a lot of feelings, Lord, of hurt, feelings of a great loss, of grief. Lord, we're hurting, Lord, in our hearts. So, Lord, we need you today to touch each one of us here. Give us an extra strength of courage and faith. and wisdom, Lord, so that we can get through this day and get through the days to come, Lord, because they will also have a missing piece. But Lord, with your help, with your strength, and with your wisdom, Lord, we will be able to go forward until that one day that you come to take us home, so that we might be reunited with our loved ones and be with you, Lord, for eternity. Lord, that's what you promised us, Lord. That's what we expect, and that's what we know that will happen. So, Lord, touch each one that's here today with your mighty hand. Give them strength and comfort, Lord, and keep us always looking up towards you for all our strength and all the things that we need. Lord, we love you, and we thank you so much. Amen. At this time, we'll have a song, I'll Fly Away.
It's an honor to be here this morning to remember Mary's life. I'm a distant relative on her mother's side of the family, and I know that family was very important to Mary and has always played an important part in her life, and want to recognize that this morning before we share scriptures, that Mary was preceded in death by her maternal grandparents, Floyd and Mary Lou Bowles, and her paternal grandparents, William and Daisy Trent, and her beloved uncle, Reggie Bowles. We also want to acknowledge that Mary leaves behind a loving family. She's survived by her loving husband of 17 years, Chris, her two children that were the joy of her life, Megan Burnett and Nathan Rowland, her father, Richard Trent, her mother and best friend, Betty Gail Trent, and her sister and her husband, Amy and Kenny Ritz, and so many more family members that are here today. And while we suffer through grief and loss, it's important to remember that the love that we have for one another is what sustains us in times like these. For those of us that have faith, we've heard it said many times that God is love. And if we truly believe that our loved ones go to be with God, and we love one another, and we love God, then truly, we're not that far apart. Death does not destroy love. And that love will remain with us all of the days of our life. And that as we move forward, those of us who knew Mary, loved Mary, were related to her, we carry her memory and her legacy with us in our lives and in our hearts. And that doesn't go anywhere. And you will see that as time goes by and years go by, pieces of her in you. I've seen that many times and experienced that with the loss of my own mother many years ago, that love remains, it grows stronger, and you see that in yourself, and you see their characteristics in you, and things will bring back memory and joy. In talking with Betty the other day, we wanted to celebrate Mary's life and choose a couple of scriptures that talk about what Mary has gained and focused on that, because so often in funerals we focus on what it is that we feel that we have lost, and the void and the struggle and the pain that we experience. And Mary went through a lot of suffering these last couple of months, but she's at peace now and at rest. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. "He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Do you believe this? And in John's book of Revelation, John shares with all believers the hope that awaits for all of us that believe. He says, "Now I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. Also, there was no more sea. Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, 'Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away.' Then he who sat on the throne said, 'Behold, I make all things new.' And he said to me, 'Write, for these words are true and faithful.' And he said to me, 'It is finished. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he will be my son.'" Amen. So Mary's race has been run on earth. It was tragically short. I went to school with her and knew her pretty much her whole life. In life, loss is hard, and it's especially tragic when you lose someone so young. But one thing in life that we're not promised is time. We're not promised the number of years or that life will always be easy. But we each have the gift of the time that we have. And more important than the length of the time that we have is the quality of the time that we have. Each day that we have is a gift. It's an opportunity to share our love with one another, to give of our hearts. 43 years is a long time if it's full of love, and Mary's life was full of love. As my father said, this has been tough for so many people. When you go through trials and you see the suffering and the things that people have been through. But it's important for those of us who are believers to realize that death is a part of life. It's a journey that each and every one of us will make. And the older we get, the more times we have to walk down this road. But as Mary leaves this world, she leaves her troubles and her suffering behind. Jesus promised new life as he said, "I am the resurrection and the life," that death does not end life. Life begins anew in God's heavenly kingdom. And the promise and revelation for all of us that there will come a time where we won't face death anymore. There won't be any more tears. There won't be any more sorrows. That God will be there, that we will have a new body, and the rest of our days will be days filled with love and with joy, and that we will be reunited with those loved ones and family members who have gone on before. And when we think of passing in those terms, we realize that life in the heavenly kingdom is better than the life that we have here. And they're at peace. So let's hold true to the love that we have for one another until that day comes when we will be reunited with God and our loved ones and Mary. And may the Lord give you all peace and strength and love and hope to sustain you all these days until those days where we are reunited again.
At this time, I want to, my youngest son, Mike, is going to say a few words. He was in Mary's class at church and Vacation Bible School, Sunday school, and they went through school together. And he happens to be a pastor also. And Betty asked if he would like to say a few words. So I'm going to let Mike come and say a few words about his personal memories of Mary.
Well, like many of you, I have been heartbroken over what has transpired with Mary, and it gave me a lot of time to think about Mary. And I thought about some of my earliest memories with Mary and everything that revolved around my earliest memories with Mary involved a school bus. I don't know if many of you ever had the privilege to ride a school bus before, but I can remember when I was young, I was a year younger than Mary, and I remember the cute girl that had the prettiest eyes and the prettiest smile riding the bus, and that was Mary. And one of the things that I got to know as I got a little bit older was that Mary was so much more than a cute smile and pretty eyes. She was a beautiful person, not only on the outside, but on the inside. I never saw Mary say a harsh word to anyone. I never saw her exclude anyone. And those are things that as you get older, you really value and you appreciate in a person. And when I thought about Mary, I thought about the things that I remember being so important to her when she was younger and as she grew older. That was her faith, her family, and her friends. And I didn't get to see Mary as much as we grew older and went different ways as life often takes you. But I can see by all of the people that have come today to show your love, to show your appreciation, and show your support, just what an impact that Mary made on this world. And when I think about what's important in this life, I think it's the legacy that we leave for those that are left behind when we go. Mary left a legacy of love. She left a legacy of faith and family and friends. And I believe that she would want us to continue that and to carry on, to celebrate our lives, celebrate each day that we have. Each day that we have truly is a gift. As my brother mentioned, we don't know how many days that we have, but we do know that each and every day we have the opportunity to make it the best day possible. And I think that Mary spent her life making her days the best days possible. And to her family, I can't express to you how much sorrow that I have for your loss, for her friends, for each person that's here. We will miss Mary. We will miss her smile. We will miss being able to see her and talk to her. But the one thing that I know above all things is that Mary is still here with us. She's only a thought away. The influence and the impact that she had on each of us will last with us long after this day has come and gone. And I'm thankful for the opportunity and the privilege to have gotten to know Mary I wish I could have gotten to know her a little better. And I think that opportunities like this give us the chance to realize that we need to spend time with our loved ones. We need to reach out to each other. We need to let each other know that we love you. You know, those are the words that are most important in days like this, to let your loved ones know that they are loved. Mary was surrounded by a lot of people that loved her. I'm sure that if she could tell us right now, she would tell us what a blessed life she was able to live. And I know that my life was blessed for having the opportunity to get to know her. She helped me in lots of different ways. I reached out to one of Mary and my mutual friends, Raphael Cam Holtz, who was Raphael Dixon when we were kids. And Raphael wanted me to express to each and every one of you that some of her earliest memories of Mary were them playing Barbies together. And I can only imagine what precious memories they were for both Mary and for Raphael. For me, my memories are many different ones, but it's mainly growing up and knowing that no matter where I went and as I grew up, that I had a friend, whether that was a friend on the bus, whether that was a friend in school, or when I grew older, if I had needed Mary for anything, I know that she would have helped me and I would have likewise done the same for her. I count it a blessing to have known Mary and to continue to tell people about the fine person that she was. I want each and every one of you to think about in your life, are you happy with the life that you're living? Is there anything that if today was your last day that you would want to change in your life? Is there anything that you would want to tell someone if you had the opportunity to tell them? Those are the things that we need to think about. When we think about our loved ones, when we think about days like this, we need to think about what would they want us to do with the time that we have. You know, each and every one of us do our absolute best to honor the memories of our loved ones that have gone on before us. That's part of our obligation and our duty. When you love someone, to let their memory survive. As my brother said, it might be through something that you find yourself becoming more like that individual, a habit, or just starting to think more like maybe your mother thought, more like your grandmother, whoever it may be. But for each and every one of us, we need to make sure that we let the memories of our loved ones live through us. And one thing that, as I prepare to close and what I'm saying, Mary, I know, would have been so proud of the life that she was able to live, for the family and the friends that she had, for her husband, for her children, for the impact that she made on this earth. You know, for each and every one of us, there will be a day that will be our last day. And I want you to think about what would be the legacy, what would be the things that someone might be saying about the life that you've lived. It's never too late to make a difference in this world. And I know that Mary Ann made quite a difference in this world. She made a difference in my life at a young age, and she made a difference in each and every one of your lives because you took the time to come and celebrate her life. And today, for as sad of a day as it is a celebration. Mary's at home. She's not suffering. She has run the race. She has fought the good fight, and she is victorious. Thank you.
Well, as we say goodbye to Mary's body today, we need to realize that she's not there today. This is the body she used while she was here on this earth, but her spirit's with the Lord. She's with the Lord today, and I know she is happy and rejoicing to be there because God said that's how it would be. He said there would be only happiness and joy. And as I think about, you know, Mary and her life, even though she wasn't here with us, for as long a time as some people. She was here for the amount of time that God's plan allowed her to be here. I truly believe that we'll be here as long as God has a plan for us to be here and a purpose for us to be here. And when that time comes, He'll take us home, and we'll be reunited with our loved ones and be rejoicing and looking back and thinking how much we care about those we left behind. And I was thinking of a poem I know that you've probably heard it before, but it talks about the importance of the time that we have. You know, the day that we're born is a joyful day. A new baby coming into the world is joyful. The day that we leave this world is usually a day of sorrow and grief. But neither of those days are as important as the time that we're here. And this poem talks about that. It says, I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend, and he referred to the dates on her tombstone from the beginning to the end. That's how he starts out this poem. And if I know Mary, the loving person that she was, she would want all of us to hear this, because we don't know how much time we have. And that's a terrible thing to talk to people. And I've heard it so many times, and I think we are all probably have had these times that we wished we might have said something that we didn't say, or we wished that we might have let someone know how much we cared about them, and we weren't able to do it. I know that a loving person is not afraid to say, I love you. Now, if you think about that, those are beautiful words. God is love. But it's so hard for some people to look at another person and say, I love you. Now, that doesn't mean that we're, there's different kinds of love in God's kingdom. And I'm talking about the kind of love that God represents to us when He sent Jesus Christ into the world and said, I love you so much, I'm going to send my only Son into this world to live with you, to walk with you, and ultimately to die for you, for your sins. That's the kind of love I'm talking about this morning. You know, we have the love between a husband and a wife, a brother and a sister, our relatives, our friends. And sometimes it's hard for people to say, I love you. But if we miss an opportunity to tell someone how we feel about them, we never know if we'll get another chance. So if Mary could tell us today what's important, I think this poem would sort of sum it up. And I'm going to continue on with that. And this man, he referred to the dates on her tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that the first came the date of her birth, and he spoke of the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For that dash represents all of the time that she spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we live and we love and how we spend our days. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way the other people feel, and be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? Well, certainly this morning, or excuse me, this afternoon now, you've heard a lot of kind words and loving words about Mary. And I know all of you have wonderful memories in your hearts and your mind about who she was, how she lived, what she meant to each one of us. But she's at peace now. She's at rest. She's at home with the Lord. No more sorrow, no more pain, no more suffering, no more tears. She's rejoicing with the Lord. And for most of us, we understand, as we've lost loved ones that are very close to us, they're we know that they're never very far away. And I know and I believe that many times they're much closer than we realize. They'll never leave us. They'll always be in our hearts and our minds. Mary was a person that will be close to us for the rest of our lives, because she meant so much to us and was such a good person. You know, David said, King David, many years ago, he one day was crying out to the Lord. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." That was King David many, many years ago, and those words ring so true today. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all of the days of our lives, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. God is so good. God is so good. Let's bow our heads. Father, again, we thank you for this day. Lord, we thank you for Mary and her life, and Lord, allowing us to say just a few kind words, so very few, Lord, but there were so many words that could have been said today that would uplift each of us here. Lord, we thank you for Mary and her life. We thank you for her husband, her children, her mom, her dad, all of her friends and relatives. Lord, we thank you for the family. And Lord, again, we ask you to give us strength, Lord. Touch each one of us with your mighty hand. Give us courage, Lord, to go forward, knowing that although Mary's not with us here, she's with you over there. And Lord, we will soon be reunited in your house, in your kingdom. Lord, we love you. We thank you so much. Bless each one here today, Lord. Amen.